Das ist eine risky Fight. Ah, closed. If you hit it, condemn, she's dead. But he gets a kill, so it's not too bad. I didn't thought you could actually come close to winning, but it's good for you. Like, you getting ahead is just a free win at this point. Enemy team comp looks super shitty as well. Oh, wait, he is dead though. Oh, wait, Alistair? Ye? Holy shit, there's some earthing. There's some earthing. Nice, okay. I guess that's a free win then. I'm getting carried by Ye here for sure.
Here.
I'm sorry about Kaiser being ahead, by the way. It was most likely since he wanted to do the coaching, right? Yeah. Oh, that feels bad that you missed that one. Over there. You can hard shove and go mid, maybe. Since bot lane, Alistar is not there, so anyways, right? Or go Scuttlecraft. Just Wardens go Scuttlecraft, yeah. Like, they're gonna push the next wave. You might as well go for them. You can't play aggressive anyways here, since Marcy is on top side, or at least you shouldn't. Unless Zyra misses Snare. Yeah, exactly. Oh, Alistar wants to go. Go, 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 go. Zyra's dead. Oh. That's kind of fucked up. What are your summoners or Alistar summoners? Can you check? Oh, it's a cooldown though. Yeah, I trusted Alistar to go in there, honestly. I didn't expect that much Zyra damage as well. She was kind of behind. I agree with Alistar right now, but yeah, after those two deaths, it's just scaling into mid-game teamfights and picking up kills and just trying to buy time for your team. Just play passive now. Isn't it Q-Max versus Squishy and W-Max versus Tanks? I don't know, Peter. Maybe. Maybe Q-Max, yeah, you're right. Yeah. Not sure why Zyra goes Ninja Tauvis though. Like, I guess you're full AD, but still, Zyra kinda needs that burst damage for later teamfights. Since she's not gonna get a lot of gold. She wants that Liandry's and Penetration Boots damage for sure. If you can dodge side rolls later on, you basically win teamfights. I don't know. I didn't look too much at wave positioning there on it, but I don't think that was a good decision to push it. But maybe it was freezing for enemies anyways, or slow pushing into them. Then it was right. Like, enemies are mishandling their wave for sure. They just break freezes instead of keeping them, I think. Oh, if you go over there, you're not gonna get back into the game though. I think you need to catch wave, let Alistar roam here. If you miss that wave and they get tower, you get super far behind. And they die anyways, right? With Malphite. You kinda need to catch that one. You don't wanna fall further behind. You just need to go for the consistent play. Yeah, that was the right decision for sure. Just wait a second and look if Kaiser's coming back. Just last hit and if Kaiser... Okay, you can push now. Kaiser's not here. Yeah, perfect. I guess you kinda, yeah, you can't really go up there since Marcy is still mid lane and it's gonna go for top lane again. I was thinking you can get it into tower a bit earlier. That was my bet. For misjudging your push potential. But the minions are in tower range already, so they can't freeze it anyways. They're playing too defensively. Zyra should walk up here. Like, if Zyra walks up here, even Alistar can just combo her. She's ultimate, right? how Yamasam Yi is wrecking topside though. Yeah, just accept farm, it's fine. Once you have players with Rune King, you want a base basically. Up until then, you just wait. Alistar should roam map and you just solo farm, I think. Okay, there you go. Yeah, Alistar should help them play the map and you just farm back up. I don't think they go onto you anyway, so I'd rather play super scared. Even if you're 1v2, I don't think she tower dives. Which is super weird, but yeah. What else? Oh, by the way, stream, that's so weird for you since if he's tapped out, the game doesn't realize it. I'm pretty sure. That's why it's blinking so much. Yeah, just get push here. You don't have to follow them quite yet. Just go and push out the wave, I think. They're fine. Malphite is down there as well. They shouldn't lose. And then you can go for Grump most likely. Just back up and go Grump. That is kind of risky. I don't think you want to fight him. Just go Grump. Take Grump here. Take Grump here. Take Grump. Yeah, Grump was the right choice, I think. You needed to wait for Alistar to actually try something there. Yeah. You're super far behind right now, so it's kinda hard. But you don't need to do stuff. You just need to farm up and be there in teamfights. I don't think you want to go Ginzo's Rageplate game. Yeah, maybe you want Phantom Dancer, right? Yeah. It can't be the standout build, but your team has enough damage. If you can just soak some damage and survive, I think that's better than you going Ginsus and dying there. By the way, walk to lane, please. Walk to lane, please. Yeah. I mean, both are built the same way. Okay, something else you can do if you want to. Instead of doing that, you can also get stopwatch and go rage blade. But you have to get stopwatch with some back. That would work as well. And if there's a situation like that, you can just go for Grump there. Since Masayu is never gonna take the jungle camp, he's just playing topside. Zed was down there, Alistar wasn't quite there, you have nothing to do, you might as well go for that. That's how you maximize on farm. Yeah, true. Peter's true. I don't think you want to base here. I think you want to clear... Yeah, I think you want to clear the jungle camps of the bot side before you base. You don't really have gold. And then wait until Kaiser pushes them in. Your team doesn't go for objectives anyways when he is dead. Like if Kaiser doesn't push here, you can come back. But just go to the jungle camps. Kaiser is actually smart. She knows that your wave is gonna clear the enemy wave. Oh no, she just went to mid lane wave. Okay. Never mind then. And just full clear basically the jungle here. Masayu is never gonna clear them otherwise. Yeah, go for it. It's fine. Masayu wants to do enemy jungle most likely anyways. You're the carry. Can you look mid lane? Maybe Graves is. Just look there. Okay, no base. It's fine. You don't win it. You just want to get item now and help defend. Just get it. I think pickaxe, right? Pickaxe is yeah. You kinda go Raptors and then ping Baron. Since if enemy team goes bot, you can just. You should go for Baron, I think. It's a reasonable play here. You wanna play mid lane or top lane right now? Yeah, I know. I agree, you said. Okay, go for Baron, go for Baron. Actually, you might not want to go for it, but if he commits to it, you can maybe burst it in time. It's a risky play for sure. Okay, it works out though. Just. Okay, back off, back off, back off. Go mid lane. Go mid lane here. And ping Dragon. Take mid lane wave and then go Scuttle Crab into Dragon, I think. You can also take mid bot lane if that's coming in. Ye wants to split push for some reason. Yeah, bot lane wave is coming here, I think. You can take that and then you'll go Dragon after you reset. Oh, you wait here. Just go behind tower, I think. Just walk behind. Just, oh, no, never mind, never mind. Alistar wants to do it, right? You should have went for the wave, regardless, I think. You need to wait for Yi here. Pull it out, 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 pull it out. You need a Yi smite. Yeah. Okay. Try to wait. Okay, okay. Set ulted. Yi, it's fine. Push mid wave directly if she gets away. Oh, okay, you get her then. Nice. Yeah, mid lane. No. And go for inhib. And after inhib, you can go for bot tower and red buff, I think. I don't think you can quite end yet, so just go double inhib, I guess. Yeah, just push, 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 push. It's fine. They face tank. You get that one. Oh, help, help, help. Nice, exactly. Perfect. Yeah, double inhib here and then bot lane. Masi gets it on his own. So you just go to Malphite and help him. Auto swim. Okay, yeah, that's fine as well. Now you wanna go Malphite though. Just back off. There's no reason to fight. You're way stronger than them. If you fight 5v5, if you just get caught, that's just giving them unnecessary gold. And Vayne is back into the game. You can also go red buff here if it's up. Okay, yeah, they go for Yi, so you can. Oh no, no, don't. You get flanked here. I'm pretty sure you just die. Yeah, run. Yeah. I think you should have went for jungle camps instead. Go again, but I guess I'm a bit delayed still, right? Or maybe you can't hear me completely. Can you go sell your item for stopwatch maybe? Yeah, sell plate for stopwatch, I think. Okay, there you go. You can now bait Zed ultimate. A lot of Zed players don't realize that you have stopwatch. Yeah, you get carried by Yi here. Nice. Interesting game for sure. I agree, it's a weird game for sure. Yeah, no, they were irrelevant for the game, I agree. I think what would help you the most is basic team game and goal knowledge. Oh, I'm gonna swap my scenes again. Like, just explaining team comps might help you a lot. Can you try to talk again?
Sure, can you hear me?
Yeah, now I can hear you. That's super weird.
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, I think so. The first thing I never do and is taking jungle camps.
That's super important, I think.
Like, legitimately, every time I did it, got pinged off by my junglers, and now I just don't do it, but I think I should do it more.
Yeah, it depends. Like, there are a lot of the time the Grump and the Crux camp on the other side, they keep getting left by junglers, and especially after mid game. In the early game, you kinda don't wanna do it, since the jungle needs the XP, But when you're ahead, especially jungler anyways invades enemy jungle and his jungle camps stay there and aren't reset. So if you actually reset them for him and he at some point returns to them and they have higher level, then they give him more XP and gold anyways. So it's actually an advantage.
Ah, I didn't even know that mechanics was looking like that.
Yeah, jungle camps have levels. So you need to reset them anyways. It actually helps your jungle in some circumstances. Like, it's true you don't want to take his entire jungle. That blue buff was maybe a bit too much, but yeah, I kind of felt like he could do it as well if he goes top anyways again. He ignored bot lane. Yeah, yeah. And besides that, I'm pretty sure you know lane matchups already. Like, you play bot lane.
The lane's not really an issue. I actually managed to reach promo Diamond 3 on another account. I can send the link to. I'll send you private.
The thing is that most players that I play with in Diamond as well don't really understand is how your team comp wants to play out against the enemy team comp. That's especially true for ADC since ADC is mainly mechanics. That's my impression of ADC so far. ADCs usually go with their supports or around junglers. And something that I dislike a lot is, on Vayne it's not a big issue, but on Caitlyn for example, on Caitlyn you're a really good siege champ, and a lot of mid laners don't want to give ADCs mid lane, so Caitlyn will just go side wave and get caught off by a jungle assassin champ or mid lane assassin champ instead of actually going mid lane and the mage going sideways. Like Cassio goes sideways instead of Caitlyn, and Caitlyn can get tower and Cassio can actually 1v1 in enemy laners in side lane since the lane is long now. That's super weird. I see that way too rarely. You usually want to go top or bot or mid, depending if your mid lane leaves you mid lane after mid game, you just go mid and let them go side lane. But if that's not the case, you can go side lane, and the side lane you choose at that point would be depending on the objectives you want to play around next. If Baron is up, you want to go top, and no dragons are spawning in soon. Otherwise, you go bot basically. If that makes sense.
I see. Most of the time, I just throw the game because I agreed for kills and I shouldn't have the patience to just siege, which I should. I remember when I got to Diamond during preseason again as well.
Okay.
And it just pains me to just follow patiently the siege and. I kind of like playing for the kills as well, so. I guess I just have to refrain myself from overlooking the lead I have and just throwing it by taking portraits. Yeah. It's basically the main thing I have to focus on. I think otherwise the lanes I rarely lose them unless my support ends. I'm pretty sure I win like 70% of the lanes.
The trades or skirmishes you take aren't actually super bad all of the time, but even if they're 50-50, like there's a 50 chance you win since you're stronger than enemies right now, but enemies have one champion more, something like that.
Yeah, that's
your
exactly
outcome
that.
Out of that is most likely nothing since those trades happen when there's no objective up. If there's a dragon around the corner, and you can look for those trades, of course, but if there's nothing up on the map to take anyways, then those trades just give them a way back into the game. And those kills don't actually matter since they are most likely behind anyways and you give a shutdown. If you give them the shutdown, then the enemy jungler magically get half an item and you're dead for 40 seconds and can't farm up and fall behind in XP. Yeah.
And thank you very much for the coaching, man, by the way.
Oh, no, it's no issue. And another thing that you should try to look at, maybe look at some jungle champion routes.
I legitimately have no idea how to play jungle. I don't even know how it's played, so I just ignore them most of the time.
Yeah. I see that a lot. But if you actually know when junglers have opportunities to gank, you reduce the times you get killed by jungle ganks so much, and you can help set up kills with your junglers as well. Like, if your jungler passes from top side into bot side, and your wave is let's say at your tower right now, your jungler is top lane, and what you can do is try to push the wave if you're stronger, only if you're stronger and you have some knowledge about the enemy jungler. You push that wave in, and the bouncing wave, when a wave is in, when a jungler starts being bot side, will push into you again, since you just bounced it, right? And at that point, most of the enemies don't have ward since they didn't have prior before in lane. And they go for river, and that river plush is so easy for your jungler to be in. Like, he can just clear his camps, he goes into river, and enemy support basically face checks him. That's such a free gank every time. If that makes sense.
Yeah, I see what you mean. Alright, well, I'll work on that, you know. Hopefully I can reach MN again. I mean, I think I was 99 LP on this account 2 weeks ago.
Oh.
I don't know if you can see that on OPGG.
Yeah, I think you can see
that tier graph. Yeah. If you see
99 LP, fourth or 30th last month.
I'll probably go again to that soonish, but I just need to focus down and play patiently.
Yes, exactly. Okay.
Right, man. Anyway, it was fun to watch your stream, and I'll catch up your stream whenever you're on.
Okay, I stream daily, so yeah.
Oh, cool.
There you go.
Thanks a lot, man. Thanks a lot.
I'm gonna start uploading videos about jungle basics and stuff like that, and also ADC tips of how to play around jungler really soon.
Upload on YouTube or on?
Yeah, on YouTube.
Yeah. All right. I'll follow that as well.
Okay. Thanks a lot. Have a good
day. Thanks a lot, man.
Yeah,
see you, man.
Day. Good luck in your games. Bye. Okay.